Your words are beautiful. The way you connect and describe your disconnection. I lie here and watch your lips speak music of sadness and deep passions of why and who you are. But I am not really there, for this is a poem. I wish I was there in the room with your words that provide warmth like feet on a radiator in a cold bed. But I am not. I stand in my garden staring into the space above and watch my thoughts float away. I don't even try to take a hold of them, I just watch them bungee jump the constellations. I watch the Matrix, I tell you. I'm having one of those moods again, and I feel weird. You describe my mind and say you call it feeling reality. Your words are beautiful. As I feel that disconnected feeling, I crave your words and what they provide. Most people eat meat because most people eat meat. So when does it stop? It's a circle of life, I hear you say again and again, face after face. Other animals eat other animals, so why should we not? As if that justifies the daily death on your plate. Choice. And what about dairy? Why do we drink, eat, consume the milk from another animal? It's not for us, and I wonder whether you've ever wondered why you do the things you do. Most people do the things they do because most people do the things they do. So when does it stop? I recall a story you told me. It was really sad, you say. We were on a family holiday camping, and we found this little bird, a blue tit. It was struggling to breathe, flapping its wings, so my dad picked him up and held it in his hands. You cupped your hands to show me how gentle you can be. And then the bird just took one last breath and then... You can't say it. Say it, the bird died. But for me, chicken, I think, from the laugh over awkwardness, what entitles me to say that? I wonder how many people you tell this story to and to who, and if they think you're gentle and kind. Whether they say, you're so kind, Will, as you suck through a straw the milk meant for a calf who's been cast aside in a box for 8 weeks because the mother needs to provide for you. Choice. The truth is, everyone can be anything they want to be. In Spanish, they have two forms of the word to be. One that's fixed like your identity and one that's momentary like your feelings. Animals feel kindness, they feel you're gentle, so why not be? I'm not saying be vegan, it's not an identity, but the second be kind, please. When you open your mouth to speak, you disappoint me. Like the moment your biscuit drops in your tea and you know it's too late to recover it, I regret I ever asked you a question.